Value Analysis Techniques, MIS. Number 10, Utilize and Pay for Vendor Skills and Knowledge. What is Value Analysis? Value Analysis is comparing specified performance, the function to be accomplished, with cost value of current and alternative designs, processes and vendors. Value analysis is finding opportunity of redesign to reduce cost value. Let us do a recap of value analysis techniques advocated by L.D. Miles. 1. Avoid generalities. 2. Get all available costs. 3. Use information from the best source. 4. Blast, create, refine. 5. Use real creativity. 6. Expect and overcome roadblocks. 7. Use specialists for in-depth knowledge and latest knowledge. 8. Put a dollar sign on tolerances. 9. Use vendors' available functional products. 10. Pay for vendor skills. In this video, we are looking at the technique 10, utilize and pay for vendor skills and knowledge. This principle is used very effectively by Japanese. It is now part of Lean, the Japanese industrial engineering practice. The alternative to design in-house is to inform suppliers with special know-how and equipment, the functions needed or required, and form requirements and limitations, and ask them to design and give the quotation for supply of the component or sub-assembly or the assembly. Supplier designs. Suppliers do provide designs and quotations. They will be of good quality. They will be of required quality. The cost quoted can be 1/4 of the cost of do it in-house design and production. This is what is the proposition put forward by L.D. Miles. Why suppliers are able to provide components or sub-assemblies at low cost? It is because of the large amount of specialized knowledge in specific products and components, the availability with suppliers of special machines, fixtures, tooling and equipment. Also, they know the recent developments in those components and sub-assemblies in which they are specializing. Hence, a firm benefits by asking supplier to design, develop and produce their special requirements as per the needs of the original equipment that they are designing. Supplier involvement in development. This particular point is noted by L.D. Miles. Suppliers are normally involved when performance deficit occurs. That is, if in-house designer fails to produce components that perform, suppliers are called in and their designs are used. But the same thing is not done in cost value context, because value analysis is not being done adequately. It is industrial engineers who have to do value analysis and value engineering. It is important to note that these two steps were indicated by C.P. Going in 1911 itself. Industrial engineers have to analyze and find opportunities for reducing cost, and in the second phase, which is the productivity engineering or efficiency engineering, they have to redefine. What C.P. Going said is being promoted now by Professor Narayana as a part of his functions of industrial engineering and focus areas of industrial engineering. Product industrial engineering and process industrial engineering are the two channels through which industrial engineers do productivity improvement and cost reduction. Example 1 regarding springs. A value analysis and engineering team studied three springs and approached a vendor for involvement. After some days, they found vendor is not contacting them. They inquired and vendor told them as they gave an exact drawing, he cannot do anything further because the engineer who made the drawing will get offended. Then the value engineering team spoke to the engineer who designed and made him speak to the supplier. Only then the supplier proceeded with the design activity and provided quotations which gave benefit to the company. Supplier involvement recommended practices. LD Miles recommended certain practices for effective supplier involvement. Because LD Miles is himself a purchasing man, before he created the value engineering, he knows the area quite sufficiently. He said, locating best suppliers requires effort on the part of the OEDM, that is original equipment design and manufacturing firm. The suppliers do not know the requirements of the various companies. The OEDM only has to search out the suppliers with the skills and equipment. Adequate description of function and form requirements have to be developed. And also the economic and competitive situation has to be stated clearly. The suppliers do expect that more than one supplier may be contacted by the company. Also, the in-house team also may be asked to do a design on their own. So suppliers are prepared to face the competition. After asking for the design and quotations, the company has to allow technical people of supplier firms sufficient opportunity to know all intricate issues relating to the component sub-assembly. When the proposed designs are submitted by the suppliers, the designs are to be reviewed objectively and communication of shortcomings is to be given. There has to be collaboration between the original equipment firm and the supplier for improvement. The volume to be given on order has to be committed beforehand. Whoever or whichever is the successful firm, it should be given the committed volume. Presented by Professor Narayana K.V.S.S, the global top industrial engineering block, industrial engineering knowledge center, NRAW IEKC blogspot.com.